Hello again, and it's Philip Druzhinin from Russia. Today we're gonna make another video about the mining processes, ancient mining. And of course, we're gonna start with some new type of mining. It's called, looks that way. So they do something. It's called a block caving mining operation. So this is how it looks actually, and for some reason they do it, and it's, of course, it's less expensive than original or maybe classical mining, when you do a drilling and then you go inside and do something to mine. Or maybe it's even less expensive than a quarry mining, when you have an open space mining and stuff like that, with rock excavation and those terraces and stuff like that. So in modern times we use this block caving mining also, and it could have been used in ancient times. And this video is about to prove you that ancient people used that mining too. This is how it looks inside the mining process, block cave mining. And that's how it's done. So it could be done pretty easy, because it's a technological process, and as I said, it's more cheap. So this is how it looks when they do it. This ground just falls on the ground, I don't know how you name it, and we see this type of operation here. This is what they do on the hill. They dig below the hill and just mine off what's blown off. That's the way they do it. So they do little caving in the surfaces, and then they drill, and this ore that's fallen down from these layers, which consist of ore, it just falls, and then they take it away with those wagonettes or whatever. And this is a train that's taking this stuff outside. That's how it looks. And we actually see those ancient caves in some places where it looks like that, and this is the way ancients dig the holes, and then they blow all those explosions inside. But right now we have a strange thing that all around the world we see these things like that, those holes. This is what happened in the United States on 21st of February in 2016, almost a year ago. I don't know where it was, but I bet you can find it by yourself. So in the middle of the field, it just ground fell down there, and this is the hole in some Asian place. In just a couple of hours, all those fish and all those biological creatures were sucked in this hole. There's another one, and there's another one. And what I'm trying to say is that after that ancient mining, already a couple centuries passed, as you know, and who knows what's going on underground right now, and this stuff is just moving around, and maybe somewhere somehow it doesn't hold on anymore, and just all this ground is swallowed by the underground levels. Or maybe someone is mining right now. That's not very crazy to think about it. Why not? Why not? We don't know nothing. As you can say, we're just on the basement level of the pyramid, and the pyramid of knowledge and awareness and information. We are, when I say we, I said all the truth seekers, all these researchers and stuff like that. But this is totally crazy when we see this occurring all over the world, and no one gives any decent explanation. Only the gas bubbles blows and stuff like that. Just, you know, this is crazy, because this is definitely the mining process. And when they say, oh, it's just something strange happens here. We know something strange happens here, but we don't know what really is, because we can't give any diagnosis. We can't even describe what's the cause of it. We can only guess. So you're like living in this house close to this hill and stuff like that, and you think, oh, that's a good place to live, why not? And one day you return home and you see this occurred. What caused that? What was the reason of that? No one knows. They're just guessing, you know. It's totally crazy. And it's everywhere. It can occur in a big city, it can occur in the field, it can occur anything. We don't know anything about what's happening underground. And what happened in the ancient times, we also don't know. We look at this and we think it's natural. Like, it's a some landscape, you know, beautiful place and stuff like that. But actually, it's the cause of mining. It could be a cause of mining, this blocking, caving process. You know, this is crazy. Some people, you know, have to descend down there and check it out, but no one gives an exact answer what was the cause. They just can't guess. And sometimes a gas bubble does come off, and they like measure the gas level in this ground, you know, take an analysis of that, or in this ice or stuff like that. But sometimes there's nothing to guess, and they guess. Like this in the street of Fukuoka in Japan. It's November 212, or November, it's November. November of last year, man. And we see that happened, and this is crazy. That happened also last year in Venezuela. And look at this. Someone dumps this byproduct in the middle of nowhere. It appears, and it looks like this crazy crater or whatever. How did it appear here? No one knows. This is totally crazy. When you see this, you think they're fooling us, they're laughing at us. What the hell they do with us? Just a dump of rock and all these byproducts of mining. We have some more ancient things, and this is the same. They consist of these stones everywhere. Just a pile of underground mining dump. Think about it. Maybe you see you have something similar near your house, so you can go outside and picture. So there's no mountains outside, and just this pile of rocks, just a dump of these byproducts. You know, this is crazy. So thank you people for watching, and I hope we're gonna proceed on this mining and technologies and stuff like that. I'm gonna search for more ancient mining for you guys to prove that it was possible. The ancient had the same technology we have, but they were more advanced, and they did a more greater, more huger job than we did. So thanks a lot for watching. See you later. Bye.